하나, 둘, 셋! 안녕! Today I'm going to be going over HoChing, which translates to titles in English, but this doesn't really encompass the whole meaning of the word. HoChing refers to the name that you call your friend, your family, or really anyone. So let's go over them in families. Parents won't use these, won't use HoChing for their kids, they'll just call them by their names. But between siblings, you'll use 형, 오빠, 누나, 언니. If you're a boy and you're calling out to an older brother, you'll say 형. Or if you're calling out to an older sister, you'll say 누나. And if you have two siblings, two older siblings, you'll usually say 큰 형, 작은 형, which refers to oldest brother and youngest brother. Or if you have more than two siblings, you'll say 첫째 형, 둘째 형, 셋째 형, and it goes on. And it's the same for 누나. You can say 큰 누나, 작은 누나, or you can say 첫째 누나, 둘째 누나, 셋째 누나. There's also 형아, which is another variation of 형, and more younger kids will call their older brothers 형아. I mean, they might say 형, but when they're really babies, they'll say 형아 a lot. There's also 형님 or 누님, and this doesn't really happen between siblings to say, but you say this with like more older people to show your respect. If you're a girl, you call 오빠 for older brother, and you'll say 언니 for an older sister. And the same rule applies here. You'll say 큰 오빠, 작은 오빠, or 첫째 오빠, 둘째 오빠, or 큰 언니, 작은 언니, 첫째 언니, 둘째 언니. If you're an older sibling and you're calling for your younger siblings, this isn't an actual name, but they'll really just say 야. Or this isn't too common, but you'll hear it actually a lot used for maybe K-pop groups, because 막내 means the youngest. So in a family, they'll say like 막내야, and they'll be referring to the youngest child. And if there's a word for the youngest, which is 막내, there's also 마지, which is the oldest sibling. And just as a side note, if you're watching like K-pop groups, you'll know that there's a 막내, but sometimes the oldest group member will be called the 막내. And this has a combination of the word 마지, which is like the oldest, and 막내, which is the youngest. So this is saying that the oldest member acts like the youngest, and the youngest is known to be more childish and more cute. So that's why they call them 막내. For example, in the group Winner, Jinu is the eldest 형, but he's called the 막내 because as the oldest, he still acts like the youngest. There's also Nayeon from Twice, who's the oldest member, but because she's like very cute, they call her the 막내 too. When kids call for their parents, they'll say 아빠, 엄마, or 아버지, 어머니, or 아버님, 어머님. And this is the same as like dad, father, or mom, mother. When you're younger, you'll usually say 아빠, 엄마, but as you grow older, you'll say 아버지, 어머니. And after your parents have passed away, or when you're writing a letter, you'll use 아버님, 어머님. This is how you show respect. These names like 형, 누나, 언니, 오빠, they apply to friendships as well. For example, in Psy's Gangnam Style, 오빤 강남 스타일, 오빤 강남 스타일. The lyric is 오빤 강남 스타일. And he's referring to himself as the 오빠, as if he's talking to a younger girl. And Gangnam is a very rich, popular, and fashionable town in Seoul. So Gangnam Style is saying that I'm like Gangnam. I'm very rich, I'm popular, I'm fashionable. And so Psy is saying, I'm this type of guy. Oh, like I'm that impressive. 오빤 강남 스타일. You'll actually hear the word 오빠 in the BLACKPINK song BOOMBAYAH. There's also 선생님 and 사장님. 선생님 directly means a teacher, and kids will call their teachers 국어 선생님, 영어 선생님. But now actually kids say 선생님 fast and just say 쌤. But 선생님 can also be used in a different setting. So It's mostly when a worker is dealing with a customer, and because they don't really know their occupation, they'll just say 선생님, and that's their way of being respectful rather than just not calling them at all. Or you could refer to them as 사장님 too, and 사장님 means a boss. You're referring to like an authority. And as these relationships grow closer over time, the older person will mostly say 언니라고 불러, or this means call me 언니 or any of the other 호칭. And this shows that you've gotten a lot closer with them, and rather than this very exact strict boundary of being like a customer and or a client, you've grown closer and you're more like friends. The best example for this would be in Squid Game. Ali, Abdul, and Jo Sang-woo have, in the beginning, they have a very kind of business relationship almost, but it's where Sang-woo helps out Ali in some small ways, and Ali keeps calling him 사장님 at the end of every sentence. And this is his way of showing his respect, especially because he doesn't really know him, but he knows that he's older and he's more giving, so he's trying to show his gratefulness.
기다렸다가 버스 타고 가요.
안 돼요. 나 돈 없어요. 돈 못 갚아요.
갚으라고 안 할 테니까 그냥 가지고 가요.
감사합니다. 감사합니다, 사장님.
나 사장님 아니니까 사장님 소리 좀 그만하고.
미안합니다. 감사합니다. 감사합니다.
And throughout the show, you'll actually see that Sang-woo continuously tells him, I'm not your 사장님, I'm not your boss. But because Ali isn't really used to that, he keeps calling him 사장님. Until one point, Sang-woo says, just call me 형. And this is a really great moment because it shows how close they've become and they formed like this trust and bond between each other.
이건 먹어요. 아까 식사 시간에 안 먹고 아껴둔 겁니다. 사장님 주려고.
이걸 왜 안 먹고 날 줘?
오늘 사장님 덕분에 살았습니다. 감사하고 싶었습니다.
감사할 거 없어. 내가 살자고 한 일이야.
사장님 자비도 줬습니다. 받으면 돌려줘야 합니다.
됐지? 알리라고 했지? 몇 살이야?
알리는 33살입니다.
그럼 그냥 형이라고 해?
그래도 됩니까? 형?
여긴 어떻게 왔어?
한국에 돈 벌러 왔습니다, 형.
아니, 한국 말고 여기 이 게임.
돈이 없어서 왔습니다, 형.
가족은?
파키스탄에 엄마, 아빠, 동생들이 있습니다. 그리고 한국에 와이프랑 베이비 있습니다.
애가 있어? 몇 살인데?
한 살 아들입니다.
보고 싶겠네.
네. 형은 왜 왔습니까? 여기?
돈 없어서 돈 벌러.
However, in the captions, whenever Ali calls him 형, it'll just translate to 상우. And this doesn't really have the same meaning because it's just him calling 상우 by his name. But 형 is a more deeper meaning of being close to someone and actually knowing them. In episode 6, they play the marble game, and eventually Sang-woo betrays Ali and takes all of his marbles. However, even in this moment where Ali's being betrayed, he still calls for Sangwoo, saying Sangwoo-hyung, which is still translated as Sangwoo in the captions. And really, Sangwoo-hyung has a very deep meaning because throughout their whole history together, he's grown from this 사장님, like a boss and worker relationship, to a closer 형 and 동생, which is like younger relationship, where he has some reliance on Sangwoo because he's continuously helped him throughout the game. However, in this moment where he's literally being stabbed in the back, he's still looking for Sangwoo and calling out to him as 형.
원래 우리 계획대로 다시 너랑 나랑 한 팀으로 승부할 수 있어. 우리 둘 다 같이 나갈 수 있어.
4번 탈락.
야, 네 손으로 나 저렇게 만들고 싶어?
278번 탈락.
어때? 이러니까 훨씬 더 안전하겠지?
네.
그럼 타이머가 3분 남았을 때 다시 여기서 만나자. 그때 작전 알려줄게. 구슬 20개야. 당신들이 말한 규칙은 어떤 게임을 하든 폭력을 쓰지 않고 상대방의 구슬을 모두 따면 되는 거였어. 난 아무런 폭력도 쓴 적이 없어.
게임 종료까지 3분. 3분 남았습니다.
형! 형! 형 어디 있어? 형! 상우 형! 나 보고 왔어요! 형! 상우 형!
Was a useful lesson for you guys on just the different types of names you might call people, and maybe you're in Korea and you'll be in a situation where you have to use one of these. So I'll see you in my next video. 안녕! 하나, 둘, 셋!